Adam Reynolds. Adam asks, my coilovers have a stiffness adjuster too. Any information how that affects use? What I'm assuming Adam is asking there is he'll have a damping adjustment. So some of the main adjustments we've got when it comes to a coilover is obviously the spring we choose and the spring rate. So the spring rate is what's defining the stiffness of the suspension at the end of the car. The adjuster that Adam will be talking about there will be a damping adjuster, and he's called it a stiffness adjuster, and that's not strictly true. It's a bit of a misnomer. It's really commonly used term. It's not really adjusting the stiffness. It's adjusting the force that the dampers will provide in response to velocity. So one of the things that's really important to understand that differentiates springs and dampers is that springs, they produce their forces in response to displacement. So how much we can press them is defined as how much force we get out of them. That's a really simple relationship. Dampers are completely different. Dampers don't provide force in response to displacement or how far we move them. They provide force in response to how fast we move them. So it's all about the speed that the damper shaft is moving at. So as far as springs are controlling how far something moves, and the dampers are controlling how fast something moves. So dampers are more about controlling. So let me start back, go back one step. Springs are about determining, let's say you're heading into a braking zone and how far it moves eventually by the time it settles is determined largely by the elastic element, so springs and bump stops. Whereas how fast it moves or how fast the front of the car dives under brakes is much more governed by your damping. So that's an example of how you use damping as opposed to changing the stiffness elements of your springs and anti-roll bars. In the same way, laterally, it's exactly the same thing. How fast the car rolls or how fast one end of the car rolls with respect to the other, which is a big part of low speed damper tuning, is controlling the relative front to rear roll rate. Dampers are much more about controlling the transients, whether it's about controlling how fast something transitioned from either dive or roll or squat, or how it deals with bumps. That's much more about what we're doing with the damping adjustments as opposed to the stiffness adjustments. So hopefully, Adam, that gives you a little bit of context about how you'd use those low speed adjust. Well, those, sorry, the adjusters. If you've only got one adjustment on your damper, and this is typical what we see in road cars, it'll generally be a low speed adjuster. And it'll usually be a low speed rebound only adjuster. That's usually the most important main tool that you've got is adjusting the rebound. If you've got two adjusters, it'll usually be low speed rebound and low speed compression. Then you've got three way adjustables, which is adding one high speed circuit. Four way, you've got high and low speed rebound and compression. And five way is where you've got that blow off setting that I mentioned before as well. So typically at more entry level, competition type dampers, you've got a single adjuster, and that's usually to adjust your low speed rebound. If you like free stuff and you'd like to learn more about optimizing the performance and handling of your car on the racetrack, as well as improving your skills behind the wheel, then we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description of this video to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You're guaranteed to learn a lot, and you'll have a chance to ask questions which we'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so click the link to claim your spot.